Today, I'm going to tell you a story about an elephant. Let's call him Ollie. Ollie was always a bit different from his peers. Different, in that he never quite got along or fit in with his buddies and family. Eventually, this led to his herd excluding him from their sojourns. Finally, banished by his family, and isolated completely, Ollie turned vicious and violent. He became what they call a rogue elephant. He went on to spend a considerable amount of time trampling and destroying crops and throwing tantrums. Ollie definitely needed some anger management. Or, at least he used to, until he was sent to an elephant sanctuary. I don't know what happened after that. Okay, but enough about this guy. Let's address the elephant in the room, which is not Ollie. Sorry. The guy I'm going to talk about is what you can call a space elephant. A massive, lone body in space that has gone rogue. And unlike our Ollie, we cannot send this guy to any sort of a sanctuary, were it to go rogue. Because this space elephant is a stellar black hole. An isolated stellar black hole, in our own backyard, the Milky Way. Orbit. Beyond the blue. For 6 years, we didn't know what the peculiar space object was, as it continued to wander aimlessly across the cosmos. But the truth always comes out. And our cosmic phantom's true face was revealed. NASA had been meticulously keeping a watch on this cosmic rogue. When suddenly, for the first time ever, it revealed itself. How? Well, trust the Hubble Space Telescope to get it done. The black hole's extreme gravity briefly magnified the light from a distant star. That little blip was all that the Hubble needed. And the cover was blown. A mass measurement proved that it was a giant black hole drifting through space. It was an exciting observation, because there are about 100 million black holes roaming among the stars in our Milky Way, but thus far, not one has ever been identified as an isolated black hole. In fact, black hole masses have only been found orbiting around normal stars, or in cores of galaxies, and they're never alone. But this one was unusual, as it was the only known isolated stellar mass black hole. Moreover, it was observed drifting about 5,000 light years away, in the Carina Sagittarius arm of the Milky Way. For scale, the nearest star to our solar system, Proxima Centauri, is about 4 light years away. So how did this isolated rogue stellar black hole come to be? What is its, as they say, sad origin story? Black holes are typically formed when a massive star, at least 20 times bigger than our Sun, explodes as supernovae. The remnant core is crushed by gravity into a black hole. The implosion may not be perfectly symmetrical, and could send the black hole hurtling into the galaxy. And, because a black hole does not emit any light, it is impossible for a telescope to capture it, while it is propelling forward in space, in complete darkness. That darkness made for a good cover, and allowed it to go completely undetected. However, a black hole is a very powerful region. Strong enough to warp space, which means that its gravity acts like a powerful lens, bending the light of the star in the background, so that it appears as two separate images, when the black hole slowly comes in front of it. Remember that cool scene from Interstellar, where our lead guy is hurtling through a black hole. Everything around him looks warped. That's because the black hole's gravity also magnifies stellar images, causing them to brighten as they momentarily line up. Our Earth-bound telescopes are continuously monitoring the brightness of the millions of stars in the central bulge of the Milky Way. And, at the same time, they are on the lookout for the sudden illumination of a star when a massive cosmic object passes between the star and us on Earth. When the black hole came under Hubble's radar, two teams, one under the aegis of Kailash Sahu, of the Space Telescope Science Institute, and the other under Casey Lamb, of the University of California. Both teams conducted independent investigations, using the data collected by the Hubble telescope. While the conclusions vary slightly, they both agree to the presence of a phantom cosmic object. The Hubble telescope has extraordinary precision needed for measurements to determine cosmic events. It was used to measure the amount of deflection of the background star's image by the black hole. The amount of deflection by the black hole's intense warping of space allowed Sahu's team to estimate that it weighs 7 solar masses. That's 7 times our sun. The team also stated that the isolated black hole was traveling across the galaxy at an estimated 100,000 miles per hour. This means that the black hole can travel from the Earth to Moon in less than 3 hours. Should it start making its way to our little planet, we would be super duper screwed to say the very least. But it's not showing any signs of coming our way yet. Despite Hubble's analysis, some doubts regarding its classification still persisted. Was it really a black hole? Every black hole we've discovered so far was because they were in a group. This isolated dude was an exception. But all doubts regarding its authenticity were cleared by Sahu and Lamb's analysis. There was no other possibility than a black hole. The lack of light from the lens and the massive gravitational force ensured that. And one more thing was confirmed for sure. This dark stellar remnant was definitely a loner. Unaccompanied by any star, alone as it hurtled through the cosmos. What a depressing thought if you ask me. Muse was right. Black holes are supermassive. And not to be messed with. Mass estimates range from 5 to 20 solar masses. Black holes detected in other galaxies, by gravitational waves from mergers between black holes and companion objects, have been as high as 90 solar masses. Can you imagine the sheer magnitude of its size? In an exciting new breakthrough, NASA's Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope, which will probably be the mother of all space telescopes, will have the capability to discover several thousand microlensing events, many of which are expected to be black holes. With this new and powerful technology, we might just find more of these lone wolf black holes as they wander in and around our galaxy, but what do I know? Orbit. Beyond the blue.